Hi, I'm Roger, a gadget guy, and I want to help you get the best from your home electronics and entertainment stuff. This is the fourth video in a four-part video series. In the first video, I showed you how to connect a modern smart TV up to any audio system using HDMI audio return channel, also known as ARC or ARC. In the second video, I showed you how to troubleshoot that type of audio connection. In the third video, I covered connecting an older TV up to any audio system, primarily using an optical connection. In this video, I'm going to give you some more troubleshooting tips for debugging an audio connection to a TV. The first troubleshooting topic I want to cover concerns a problem that was raised by somebody who saw my first video. It was a call from my son. He said, "Hey Dad, I connected it up exactly as you showed me in the video, and it sounds wonderful. The volume control works great. The only problem I have is that I turned the TV off and I got this weird Twilight Zone ghostly sound. And it happened about 20 seconds after I turned the TV off. The room was completely dark and it scared the living daylights out of me." My son was using one of the HDMI ARC audio adapters, like the one I showed you in video part one. Now, it was great that he was able to buy the right thing, get it all set up just from watching that video, and it was working great for him. The problem he had was because it's incredibly convenient to plug these in to the TV USB output. His TV turns off the USB after the TV turns off. Now, this does save a little bit of power, but it on most TVs, it just causes a little pop in the speakers, which is not that big a deal. But you can make it go away on many brands of TV. There's a menu item. On this TV, it's in the system menu and it's USB power. And you can have it always on or turn off when the TV turns off. The amount of power these things use when they're turned on is tiny. It's like a few pennies a year in terms of electricity. So you may want to leave it on to save that little pop. The problem my son had was with his Samsung TV, where the power from the TV didn't go down suddenly and cause a little pop. It went down really slowly. And while that voltage is in the twilight zone, partway between turned on and partway between turned off, it creates a twilight zone sound. So the solution for my son was to connect the USB power to a smartphone charging block and then just plug it into the AC outlet. The problem went away and his system works fine. He's very happy with it. Before we start talking about troubleshooting an optical connection, I want to talk a little bit about optical cables. At the top, you have a really cheap, skinny one, which comes free with a lot of devices. And underneath, there's a much more expensive one. And you can see how much fatter the one on the bottom is than the cheap one at the top. Well, the little secret is they work exactly the same. There is absolutely no advantage to paying extra for a fancy looking optical cable, other than the one at the bottom is a lot more sturdy than the cheap one at the top. The performance of both will be exactly the same. Now, optical cables are more fragile than a copper wire, so they should be handled with some care. And if you have a cable that has a kink in it, it's probably best not to use it. But one way to determine whether the cable has a signal going through it is to plug one end into the TV and then look at the other end to see if it's glowing red. And this one, I can see the red glow here. Let me try and get it. There you go. So this one is glowing red, which means I'm getting the optical signal through. If you have an optical connection between your TV and your audio and you get no sound, the most likely reason is because your TV is trying to send your audio system a surround sound signal. If your audio system is a stereo system, it is completely incapable of decoding the signal that's coming from your TV. And there's a very simple solution to that. And you go to your TV menu and you go to audio and go down to digital audio out. And where it says auto, which is usually the default, you just go PCM and immediately you get sound. So I have to mute this. Sometimes it's stereo is what you select. You want to avoid auto. PCM and stereo are the same thing. If you select PCM or stereo for the digital audio out, you will get sound for any programming on your TV. Another potential problem I'd like to talk about is when either the audio or the video gets a little bit ahead of the other. And that's called a lip sync problem. And read my lips and you'll see that I've deliberately offset the audio and video, and the timing's just a little bit off, and it's very annoying. A modern TV does a lot of really fancy math on every frame of video that comes in to get the absolute best possible picture for you. And that video processing just takes a fraction of a second. Now, the TV manufacturers are really good at getting the sound and video in sync. And they delay the audio just a little bit to match the processing of the video. The different video modes on this set may actually have different timings. And again, the TV manufacturers take care of that. You run into a problem if you connect a video source, like a DVD player, directly to an audio system. And if you do that via, say, an optical cable, and then connect the video up through HDMI to the TV, the sound and the video may end up being a little bit out of sync. So my advice is to connect every video source, cable box, DVDs, streamers, to the TV. Do all the switching through the TV and just have one HDMI cable go out to the audio device. One HDMI cable or an optical cable, of course. And that gets around most lip sync problems. The other cause of lip sync problems arises generally with cable boxes. And as I've shown you, if you have a stereo system connected to your TV, you want to have the TV set to stereo or PCM. Now, if the cable box is set to surround sound, then the TV has to decode the surround sound and encode the stereo, and that causes a little bit of delay that causes the audio to be a little bit behind the video, and you get the lip sync problem. Now, the simple solution to that is if you have a cable box, you go to the menus, and if you have a Xfinity cable box, you just push the Xfinity button, you'll see some choices, and you navigate to setup, and under setup, you go to audio or sound, I'm not sure which it is, and there you'll see an option to either select surround sound or stereo, and it may say PCM. So you set the audio output format to stereo or PCM, and your lip sync problem will go away. Now, if you do have a surround sound system, you want to have both the TV and the cable box set to surround sound. So whatever your video source, it's best to go into the menus and make sure that the audio output format is set to the same as you have the TV set to. If you've watched all four parts of this video series, you now know how to connect any TV to any audio system. I wish you long enjoyment of your TV and audio system. Maybe you'll be able to help friends out if they're having problems with their TV sound. If you like this video and found it helpful, then please give me a thumbs up. If you want to hear about new videos from me as I come out, then please click the subscribe button. If you go to the description of this video in YouTube, you'll see links to the products that I've shown you. If you click on those links, It will help to support the channel. That's all I have for today. Thanks for watching.